I'm on location in Tunnel Hill, Georgia, at the scene of the Western and Atlantic Railroad Tunnel, made famous by the Great Locomotive Chase.
Work started on the tunnel in July 1848 and finished in October 1849, although the first train didn't pass through until May of 1850. Until that time, trains would pull up to one side of the ridge and unload, and crews would have to haul the goods over the ridge to a train waiting on the other side.
Once the tunnel was completed, a train could get from Atlanta to Chattanooga in about 9 hours. The tunnel is 1,477 feet long. Stone masonry supports the tunnel entrances, but deep inside, the walls are held up in places by patchworks of bricks. In other places, you can see the solid rock of the hill itself, some of it scarred by drills, graffiti, and the hurried passage of trains. Safety pockets are set periodically in the walls in case someone got trapped in the tunnel as a locomotive passed.
It can be a lonely walk going all the way to the far end of the tunnel, and an eerie breeze blows through to keep you company. But there are motion-detected lights along the way as well, and they activate to keep your footpath pretty clear.
Tours of the tunnel are available courtesy of a visitor center and museum, which also offers background information about the tunnel and tells the story of the Great Locomotive Chase in April 1862. Union raiders intended to blow up the tunnel, but with Confederate pursuit hot on their trail, they didn't have time. Nearby is the Clisby Austin House, where John Bell Hood's leg, amputated after the Battle of Chickamauga, is buried in the family cemetery. Also in this house, in December of 1863, Patrick Claiborne wrote his proposal to draft slaves into the army in exchange for their emancipation. During the Atlanta campaign, Sherman made his headquarters here after driving away Confederate defenders.